ArrayList in Java. Okay, the class ArrayList. So it's important to know that ArrayList is not part of the program or part of the Java programming language syntax. It's just a class, and so to access its data, we have to use methods the way we normally do for a class. Okay, so you can see it's a standard class. It encapsulates the functionality of an array, but allows it to expand automatically. So when we're dealing with array list, we don't have to define the fixed size of an array list. It can expand itself automatically. Okay, so it's also is a class. It's not part of the Java syntax. So to access this data, you have to use methods. Okay, so this is an example of how to create an array list. It's quite simple. What to do? First of all, it's important we know that an array list comes from the java.util class. Okay, so we initialize the array list. This is after importing the java.util. Then like array list countries is equal to new array list. Then to add, we use the add method. Okay, then to remove an object from the array list, we use the get method, this one over here. Okay, then to get the size of an array list, we use the size method. To remove an item from an array list at a specific index, use the remove, and then we pass the integer for the index. Okay, to remove everything, to clear an array list, we use the clear method. Okay, so that is what we're going to do in today's class. So please fire up your IDE. Today I'm using NetBeans. Okay, so once you are fired up, come here, or your file, new project. We're going to do to start a new one from scratch. So let's choose Java application, then click next. Okay, then our program, we're going to name it ArrayList class, ArrayList lesson. Okay, yeah, it has loaded very fast. I'm going to remove these comments. Normally when I'm doing this work, I usually don't like so many things on the screen. Okay, so this is our class. To use this class, first of all, we'll be needed to import a certain class, but let's just start. We will see array list, let's name it countries is equal to new array list. Okay, and then you see it will bring us an error, meaning that it cannot find that symbol. Okay, so what you'll do, just right click and then come to fix imports. Okay, just right click in that error, you will see the class it has imported for us automatically, java.util.arraylist. okay, so that's the class. We can now start using it. We can add items. Add items to array list. I normally like commenting everything, so please don't mind. This one here is creating an array list. Okay, so to add, we come and say country dot add, let's say US. Okay, then countries dot add, which other one, let's say probably India. Then countries dot add, let's say probably Britain, okay, Britain, then countries, okay, last time we add, let's say a country from Africa, let's even say Kenya, okay. So that one we've added items in the array list. Then to retrieve the items, okay, let's see, to get the size of the array list, get the size, we just come and say system dot out dot print, and then say there are then come there and add countries dot size, okay, then plus countries, okay. Then let's run our program and see. When we run the program, okay, it's building. You can see there are four countries. That is the size. That is how we get the size of in an array list. Then when we continue, that one we've gotten the size. We want to now retrieve the items. Get the individual items. We come and say system dot out dot println, then we say I have gone to the following countries, and then probably say we now in this other one, okay, we should be getting, okay, a mistake, we should be using a loop for int I is equal to 0, I is less than countries dot size, okay, then I plus plus. A basic error I was making. So here we come and put plus countries dot get I, okay. So what this thing will do is that it will loop through all the countries in the array list, okay, and then it will be printing each country. We've used the get method in this example to get the countries. So when we run the program, you can see I have gone to the following countries, USA, India, Britain and Kenya, okay. So that is how to get the individual items. Now let's see how to remove items from an array. So to remove an item from an array, okay, we want to use the index. So using index, I'll just come and say countries dot remove, and then I pass the index. Let me say I want to that one, okay. Now when I come and get the size, you'll find that it will be different. System dot out dot print ln, and then say I am now remaining with countries dot size. And then plus countries. Okay, that is how to remove using an index. So when I print, when I run the program, let's see the outcome. I am now remaining with three countries, okay, meaning that it successfully removed the country. So to remove an item from an array list, we use remove method. Now let's see how to remove everything. Remove everything. Now to remove everything, we use dot clear. It's very simple. Countries dot clear. Okay. And when we run, okay, let's say system dot out dot print line and say, let me copy this one. Put it over there. Okay, now when I run the program, let's see the outcome. I'm now remaining with zero countries. Okay, so thanks folks for listening. Please subscribe, and I think I can see you next time. Okay, thanks.